Now let's go back to the phases within a cycle, because I want to show you how they relate to the traditional activities of software development, because this is the first time that we talk about inception, elaboration, construction, and transition. So we don't know what they mean in terms of the traditional software development. So I'm going to first discuss these relations, and then I'm going to talk about each individual phase in further detail. So I'm going to start by representing the four RUP phases here with possible internal iterations, I1, E1, and E2, C1, C2, and so on. And just as a reference, this is the way in which time will progress. So we will start with inception and we will finish with transition. So what I want to do now is to show the actual traditional software development activities here on the left. And I also want to show you, using this diagram, how these activities are actually performed in each of the RUP phases. So let's see what this representation means. Basically, what I'm showing here is that requirements engineering actually starts in the inception phase. So you can see the height of this bar as the amount of effort devoted to this activity in this specific phase. So you can see that requirements engineering starts in the inception phase, is mostly performed in the elaboration phase, and then it continues, although to a lesser extent, throughout all phases, up until the end of the transition. But the bulk is really performed here in the elaboration phase. Similarly, if we consider analysis and design, we can see that analysis and design are mainly performed in the elaboration phase, but a considerable amount of it also continues in the construction phase, and then it kind of phases out. So there's very little of that done in the transition phase. Looking now at the implementation, you can see that the implementation happens mostly in the construction phase, which is, unsurprisingly, the phase that is mostly concerned with actual code development, as we will see in a minute. Testing, on the other hand, is performed throughout most phases, with peaks in some specific point, for example, at the end of some iterations, like here and here. And to conclude, we have the business modeling activity that happens mainly in the inception and a little bit in the elaboration phase, and the deployment activity, which happens a little bit throughout, but the bulk of it is really in the transition phase, which is actually the phase that has to do with deployment and then maintenance. So I hope this kind of high-level view give you a better understanding of what is the mapping between these new phases and the typical software development activities that we are more familiar with. So to further this understanding, later in the lesson, I'm also going to talk about these specific phases individually. First, however, I want to spend a little more time discussing on what happens inside each one of these iterations, just to make sure that we all understand what an iteration is exactly.